Hello, everyone. Oh, welcome back to our Bible study. It's been a while. I didn't see you. Now we are going to continue Unit 7 of our Bible studies. I know you've been listening, paying attention, and enjoying this. So now let's continue. But before we do that, let's pray. Close your eyes and pray with me. Father God, we thank you, Lord. We bless you. We thank you for these children. We thank you for what you are doing in their lives. We thank you for their families. We thank you for each and every one of us, oh Lord. We pray, Father God, that your word that we're going to sit to listen to, you will help us, Lord, to be good listeners. But most importantly, that we'll be able to implement it in our lives. We pray, Father God, that this, your word, oh God, from the Bible, Lord, you're going to help us to digest it, to listen, and walk according to how you want us, Lord. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, as I said in the beginning, we're going to continue with Unit 7. And this time, we're going to study about Joshua and Caleb. That's what we're going to study. What happened? I don't want to explain everything. Our focus for this study is going to be in Numbers 13, 14. That's where we're going to focus. Numbers chapter 13 and chapter 14. Here is the Bible. This is the word of God, the true word of God. So whenever we're going to study, we look through the Bible and study what God wants us to study. Okay? I don't want to say everything right now. I don't want to tell you what you're going to see, but I'm sure you're going to watch a video about the story, and then you're going to have to dance with all the movements. And then later, I'm coming back so that I will tell you the final thing about that, a summary about that. So please listen, sit down, remove everything that is going to distract you, and shh, listen. Okay? See you soon.
God's people had traveled out of Egypt and were almost to the promised land. God told Moses to send men to scout out the land of Canaan. This is the land God was giving to the Israelites. So Moses sent out one leader from each family tribe. Moses told the leaders to see what the land was like and whether the people living there were strong or weak, few or many. Moses had many questions. Is the land good or bad? Are the cities they live in camps or forts? Is the land good for farming? Are there any trees? Moses urged the scouts to be courageous. So the 12 scouts traveled throughout the land for 40 days. They cut down a cluster of grapes that was so big it took two men to carry it on a pole. Then they went back to tell Moses, Aaron, and the other Israelites what they saw. The land is good. It is flowing with milk and honey, they said. But the people who live there are strong, and the cities they live in are large and well protected. Then Caleb, one of the men sent to scout out the land, said, "We must go up and take possession of the land. We can certainly conquer it with God's help."
Oh no.
But other men disagreed. "We can't go up against the people. They are stronger than we are. We look like grasshoppers compared to them." The people were afraid, and they cried all night. They thought Moses and Aaron had brought them to Canaan to die. The Israelites said, "Let's choose a new leader and go back to Egypt." Joshua and Caleb tore their clothes and said again, "The land we explored is extremely good land. If the Lord is pleased with us, he will give it to us. Don't be afraid of the people living in the land. God is with us. The Lord spoke to Moses, "How long will these people not trust me?" God threatened to destroy all the people, but Moses urged God to forgive them. Moses reminded God that he is patient, loving, and forgiving. Since Caleb and Joshua had followed God completely, God decided to let them enter the promised land. God said that the Israelites who did not trust him would wander in the wilderness 40 years and they would not enter the promised land. All of the spies who went to scout out the land died before entering, except for Joshua and Caleb. The Israelites rebelled against God because they did not trust him. Jesus trusted God perfectly. He took the punishment we deserve for our sin or rebellion against God. When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sin and gives us eternal life.
Hello again. Wow. Did you enjoy the story? Did you pay attention? Let me hear you. I can hear you. Oh, of course. I know you are all fantastic children. You are good listeners. And you've listened to the story. You didn't disturb in the house. Of course, I know. So, what happened in the story? Let's see here. I know you want to talk something, but no. Wait. So what happened in the story is we saw that Caleb, the Israelites, God sent them in a place. And what happened? They rebelled against God because they did not trust him. For us as children of God, we need to trust God. We need to believe in him. We need to admit. If we do something bad, we admit that this thing is bad. And then we confess our sins. So what happened with the Israelites? God sent them in the promised land. But they did not believe in God. They got distracted and they decided to do whatever they want to do. So we see, but what happened? Jesus trusted God perfectly. He took the punishment we deserve for our sins or rebellion against God, and he took that punishment for us. And so what happened here? When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sins and gives us eternal life. So as children of God, including myself, we need to trust God. We need to believe him. When the word of God tells us do something, we do it. We don't say, "Oh no, why me?" No, I don't think you're going to do that. Are you? No. And what happened? This is short way to remember that. Remember A, B, C, which means admit when you do something wrong. And then, what do you do the next one for B? Believe in the Bible. Believe in Jesus. And then the last one, confess your sins. Confess that I'm wrong. Confess that I've done something. Jesus, forgive me. And then you continue in the good way. Believe. Okay? Now, all of it is all about trusting God. I will leave you. Guess what happened? I'm going to see you again next week. I hope you are ready to see me. Love you all. Thank you. Okay, so let's pray. Father, we thank you, God, for this day. We thank you for the story that you've taught us today. We thank you, Lord, that you've taught us to believe in you. You've taught us, Lord, that you are the only true God. You've taught us that without you, we cannot do anything. Father, we believe the story. We believe, oh God, the Bible. We believe, Lord Jesus, that you died for our sins. We pray, Father God, that you help us to walk in your ways, Lord. Help us, even as children. Father, bring your blessing in our lives. Direct our path, oh Lord. Teach us the good way. Teach us the way to walk with you. We bless you, Lord. We thank you, God, for our families and our friends. We thank you for this week as we are going to school. We're going to do different things. We pray, Father God, that you bless us. You guide and protect us. Thank you, Father, for everything. We leave everything in your hands. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Jacob from Eugene, Oregon asks,
last week, my friend promised to go to the movies with me, but an hour before the movie, he backed out. If I can't trust my friends to keep their promises, how do I know I can trust God?
That is a great question, Jacob, and it really reminds me of the difference between people and God. You see, the problem is sometimes we will make promises to somebody and we will intend to keep them. And maybe your friend had every intention of making that movie, but something came up. Maybe he got sick, or maybe his parents had something come up that they had to do as a family. And so he had to break that promise, and he didn't mean to. Other times we'll make a promise and something better will come up. We'll have something that we'd rather do, and so we choose to break a promise. And that just reveals our sinfulness, that we're all born in sin, and there are times that we do the wrong thing. The difference between us, though, and God is he's completely sovereign. He's in control, so nothing will ever come up to surprise him and make him break a promise. And also, he is sinless. He cannot break a promise because he's faithful. So while sometimes we will be let down by people, we will never be let down by God because he's in control and he's faithful. So you can completely trust in God. Whatever he says he will do, he will do. So why is it important to be a trustworthy friend then?